Sounds acceptable. Ratchet bomb is so much worse when you're on the draw. It's possible I should have just played this and hope to find an Anger of the Gods as quickly as possible. I don't know. He drew this turn, maybe? I'm a little bit confused about the sequence of cards he's played. Let's think about this. I think I'm definitely going to play this land this turn. And don't want that. If he has like Mogus, Fanatic of Mogus, I'm just dead, unfortunately. I guess he can also have Stormbreath Dragon, which would be horrible for me. I didn't blow the Ratchet Bomb because I feel like I need to get it up to the point where I can take out the hammer. Yeah, this looks like I'm just dead. Two Fanatic Moguses. Okay. My opponent doesn't understand how his cards work. He could have sacked this Nykthos right before he played this one. He's botched his turn so badly that I guess I'm just going to... I can just Ratchet Bomb the token, Ratchet Bomb the Fire Drake Crusader, play Ral Zarek and kill the Burning Tree Emissary. And, like, there isn't that much he can do from that point. He's going to have one red mana and one colorless mana in play. I guess he can activate the hammer if he has another land and just kill Ral Zarek, but that's fine. I could have taken an additional three to play around that, but I don't even think that's worth it. So if he doesn't have another land, I think his turn's basically going to be nothing. Just good for me. And then I'll have an option. The reason I have Ral Zarek in my deck is the first tap target permanent, untap another targeted permanent ability, which is actually pretty powerful with Trading Post. But I think in this case... just gonna play Jason plus it. My sequencing on those all those activations was not great. I should have used the Rouser before I cast the Jace. Just to make... I mean, my opponent obviously could have played a burn spell to kill the Rouser on his turn, but he obviously is making mistakes, so I didn't need to give him a window to correct one of them if he had forgotten to shock Rouser or something. Really confused about what's going on at this point. So I just want quantity. More Nyxoses. This looks like it's a Stormbreath Dragon. Underworld Cerberus. Holy cow. Turn Burn's a pretty good answer to the Underworld Cerberus. Why can't I sack a... I'm gonna sack a creature. Is it something with this? Oh, I can't... Wow! Cards in graveyards can't be the target of spells or abilities. Alright, I'll just get 4 life. I'm going to take the mortars, regardless of how we split them. Now I can get back a Ratchet Bomb. This is another nice interaction that my deck has. I'm gonna charge up a Ratchet Bomb extra fast. Here. Want another land in play? Probably not. I can overload mortars and activate trading post even without having to put that into play on tap next turn. So I'm gonna hold it in my hand. Might want to gain 4 life with it. Or I guess I could discard it to Izzet Charm. This isn't another underworld Cerberus. That thing was annoying. Rakdos has returned me for 5. Wow. So he's going to get to kill one of my planeswalkers with that. So he kills Ralzeric with that. And then he would attack Jace. Yeah, I guess I'm making a goat and chump blocking rather than gaining 4 life. It's a really good card for him. I suppose I don't even need to chump this turn. That was a really good draw. Question is, do I want to use it? I think I can wait. I should probably just ratchet bomb these things now, though, to constrain his mana. You might be tempted to try to use, like, Trading Post and Ratchet Bomb to, like, sack the Ratchet Bomb and sack the Trading Post, but they're both sacrifices, so that doesn't work. Glad I saved the mortars. I'm gonna cast the Ratchet Bomb. I'll use it. If he decides that he wants to just sack a land to send it at Ralzeric, I'm actually just going to ratchet bomb the land away. If he doesn't do that, I think I'm going to charge the ratchet bomb up. He's scryed to the top. There may have been an opportunity for, if I had been patienter with the Ratchet Bomb, to actually get rid of the hammer earlier in this game, which certainly would have made my life easier. that's probably a pretty good draw. Get ultimate Roserick and really hope that I don't lose 5-4 coin flips. What did I do with my... Why isn't this untapped? I screwed up somehow. I guess I untapped a land rather than... Oh, I needed to untap the trading post and play a land. That's what I did wrong. That's pretty bad. I could have set myself up way better this game. Still super far ahead, but I screwed up for sure. All right, this is going to be a good series of turns, I'm sensing. Let's start out with that. Let's do this. 5 coin flips. Oh, I lost. I lost. I lost. I won. I lost. All right, that was not very good. I will take Anger of the Gods at an island. Thank you. That's pretty good. Right, this is a sort of tricky spot with this deck in that you don't want to elixir away all the cards in your graveyard a lot of the time because it'll shut your trading post off. So you want to make sure you still have a card to be looping with trading post. So what I'm probably going to do is I'm going to try and post back a Ratchet Bomb at the end of his turn. And then on my turn, I'm going to sack, I would have sacked the Elixir and, or I would have activated Elixir, stacked it to trading post to gain 5 life and draw another card with the Ratchet Bomb still in hand. So I would still have 1 Ratchet Bomb to use with trading post. Well, that was, I guess, an enjoyable first match for me, at least. Probably not for my opponent. I'll see you guys next round.